We chew it, blow bubbles with it, then stick it in places where we should.
Did you stick all this gum under here?
I don't know.
Do you think you're at an Arby's right now?
I don't know your life.
Chewing gum can be good for freshening your breath.
Funky fresh.
Or for improving your cognitive function.
And it helps control my genital herpes.
But if you swallowed your gum on purpose or by accident.
I swallowed every piece of gum that I've chewed for the past 25 years.
How would it affect your body?
I've never seen the wrapper come out.
Would it
Adios.
Pass through your system? Or stick around?
Constipation or diarrhea?
I mean, I was constipated for 3 days.
This is your body on swallowing too much gum. Thousands of years ago, chewing gums were made of resin from mastic trees.
Hi.
Now, the base ingredients of gum are synthetic materials. Today, gum is made of elastomers, plasticizing softeners, sweeteners, and preservative antioxidizing agents. Sounds delicious.
It's only human natural.
But our digestive system can't break down these materials, except for the sweeteners.
Come give mama some sugar.
So, what happens when we swallow too much gum?
We are all going to die.
All right, let's start this challenge by having you swallow a whole pack of gum every day.
That sounds dangerous, son.
Why don't you go ahead and pick out some of your favorite flavors?
Give me a pack of tropical fruit bubblicious.
Okay, we get it. Enough showing off.
Nobody likes to show off.
You might think that the sugar-free variety would be healthier.
I know what healthy is.
But sorbitol, the artificial sweetener, can act as a laxative.
I did all the poops.
You'd feel something brewing down there within 1 to 3 hours.
You pooped in your pants.
I pooped my pants.
There are 14 to 18 sticks of gum per pack.
Oh, take enough. Mm.
And one stick contains about 1.25 grams of sorbitol.
Ooh.
Studies have found that 10 grams of sorbitol can increase gastrointestinal discomfort, while 20 grams or more is enough to cause diarrhea and abdominal cramps.
You would not believe the mother load I just dropped.
By the end of your first day, all that sorbitol would increase the water content of your stool.
Doo-doo water.
Yeah, prepare for lots of diarrhea.
I look forward to it.
Hey, but on the plus side, you might lose a little weight.
I was so lucky getting mono. That was like the best diet ever.
2 days of chewing gum could cause some bloating due to the amount of air you would swallow. It's what we call aerophagia.
He's gonna blow!
You might start burping a lot.
Gross.
Or experience non-odorous flatulence.
I can taste it.
Hey, lucky for your roommate.
It's beautiful. Thank you.
The sugars or artificial sweeteners could also alter your gut flora once they reach your colon. That could cause some inflammation and discomfort.
Is your butt okay?
I'm butthurt, man.
After 3 days of chewing gum, you'd likely suffer from temporomandibular joint disorder.
What?
Because you've overused your jaw muscles, it could cause inflammation. You'd be in pain. You could suffer from earaches and headaches in the long run. But when you're on a plane, chewing gum opens your eustachian tube, allowing the air and the new atmospheric pressure to reach your inner ear. That process evens out the pressure and relieves ear pain.
At ease, ladies.
Okay, you've swallowed 5 full packs of gum and you're feeling a little backed up.
You don't come to work for 2 days because you were constipated?
Luckily, it was only 2 days.
If you have a history of constipation,
I'm a pusher.
a wad of gum may block your bowel movements. This could cause further problems.
People do things constipated.
In extreme cases, swallowing excess gum can cause the buildup of a mass called a bezoar.
You're being poisoned.
By gum?
It's rare. It mostly happens to kids with digestive issues who swallow gum and other things like coins.
Feels like razor blades are coming out the tip.
This would be very uncomfortable and would require medical attention.
I would perform any operation for $129.95.
It usually means taking oral medication like cellulase.
Pills, baby!
To dissolve the lump, but if it's too hard to break down, it may need to be removed surgically.
I know I'm supposed to cut something, but what? And where?
Other serious situations may require an enema.
Oh, no, no, no.
That's when they take a tube and put it up your... Well, we won't go into detail.
So, so sexy.
Now, it's a common misconception to think that swallowed gum will stay in your stomach or guts for 7 years because your body can't digest it. Don't worry. By the end of the week, your body would be able to force out the gum in your poop. We'd advise drinking a lot of water to make this process less painful. So, while gum may be great for jaw exercise, freshening your breath, or holding back cravings, should you swallow it?
No. Gum is for chewing.
Yeah, agreed, buddy. But you may digest candies more easily.
My candy, you turn about big.
Do you think you'd be able to eat only candy for 1 month? Yeah, that sounds like a challenge for another episode of Your Body On.